Hi all, Hal here with 7 Days to Die, Whiterun Edition. So what we're gonna do is basically the Broken Ankle crew has finished the Whiterun build, and I wanted to take you through it really quick and just show you what has actually been achieved over the course of this build. Obviously not everybody was always there for each episode and for each build, so there was a couple of times where I was actually there and building, but I hadn't recorded for that week for various reasons. Sometimes technical problems, sometimes just because I was a noob and forgot to hit the record button at the right time. So anyway, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna approach this as though your character was actually in Skyrim. So as you can see here, we have the stables and the was this? This was the coach post, right? Well, it looks like we're missing some tiles in there now. Somebody broke them. So yeah. So your character would normally come through. You've got your first set of gates here. And for the folks who haven't played Skyrim, you might want to take a look at the map. I'll actually put a link down in the description below the video for the map, so you can see how close to the actual game we got in this build. Well, we lost some water in there. Looks like we've had some zombie damage come through. Now, one of the guys was joking that we have gone roughly 42 recording sessions on this build, and the entire time we had no trees. Somewhere in the last like 2 days, we have had a forest spawn up around everything, so. All right, so for Whiterun, as we come in, this would be the main gate and guard stations. Oh, I think we're supposed to have some stone in there. The first blacksmith shop when you first come into the city. This is where you get a lot of your starting crafting quests. We have the full blacksmith shop. They've even put the forge in over here. Now, one of the things, oh, they did put the workbench over there, but they didn't put like a tanning rack or something in. I guess we could do that. But, you know, just showing you the level of detail that was done on this build, it is just absolutely amazing. The community on the server did a lot to really make it easy for the Broken Ankle crew to come through and do the builds. So where we did a lot of the major like landmarks and things. A lot of the filler stuff was actually done by the community, as well as a good portion of the resource gathering. So without the community, a lot of this would not have been possible. So a big shout out to the community. For those who don't know, this was a community server during the build process. The server has been closed. So the only way for you to see it right now are through the other Broken Ankle crew channels, which are linked in the description below this video. If you are curious about seeing any of them from the other perspectives, definitely check them out because there's a lot of really good content on those channels. And as you can see, we've just got a bunch of little houses and stuff back here. Some of the community actually claimed the houses and turned them into their own places. Not a whole lot furnished over here, just because there was so much going on. We really didn't have time to come back and do a full furnish out on it. This is the one of the trade locations. This is actually the alchemy and potions, I guess you could say, general store. This is where you'd come for all of your healing aid and things like that. This one would be the store, the actual general store. The person that you trade with here has a little bit of everything. Kind of the black market deals and things like that would go on in there. You've got key character housing, the vendor stalls or vendors booths. Looks like we've got all of them in the town well. The Bannered Mare, this was one of the first builds that I was actually here on the server for. And I have to say, it was a lot of fun working on this build. Very, very confusing because we just had so much going on at that point in time. But again, all of our builds here are, inspired by and kind of trying to match what you would get in Skyrim. Unfortunately, you're just not able to really match everything because it's just a completely different game engine, obviously. So And you will see little areas like this where you have the guard shacks that go up into the walls. We still have some placeholder stairs so that we could get around a little bit easier when we were working on the server. But yeah. Oh, looks like we're okay. They actually did fix that. Show you what some of the tower and defense areas look like. So most of the walls were actually done by the community. They were working with, I believe, Mafke and Rongo did a lot of the planning of this. And then, yeah, see, we've got the little barracks area here. This is actually pretty nice. This is the first time I've been in this one, so. All right, so let's go ahead and we'll head up into, I believe they call it the Cloud District, which is the upper district for. Whoops. We have water in here. Oh, okay. Come on. All right. Collision mode off. There we go. All right. So you come up into the Cloud District. As you progress through the quest lines in the Skyrim game, you end up over here. There's a temple here off to the left. And then over here is. Oh, what's it called? Yggdrasil, I think. I know I'm butchering the pronunciation of that. Basically, this is where the mercenaries. I don't know if you. I guess you call them a family in this case. It's kind of a tribe of non-blood relations. They are the defenders of the realm, kind of thing. And you have the little workout area back here. The training dummies. Now, I was actually going to modify one of these. I just never got a chance to do it, unfortunately. I wanted to have one of these broken and laying on the ground over here in the corner, but we just, like I said, we just ran out of time. It was such a huge amount of effort that went into this entire process. I think we spent, that I know of, oh, probably close to about 120 hours of active building on this entire process. It was a rather unique experience. So we'll come up here. This is the Skyforge area. They haven't finished the forge. I think we were going to put a forge in here as well, and then have the fire pits here, well, the burning rubble. Did they? Yeah, he did. And so you actually do have the eagle, or as we were calling it, the parrot. So, Sid Charlie, I believe, is the one who did this particular piece. Great guy. He's actually a newer YouTuber as well. I don't think I have his channel in my normal links list, but I will see if I can put it in there for those who are interested in seeing more of his stuff. I'm not sure how much of the behind the scenes he was showing, so we won't go up there yet because that is the palace. But what we will do is we'll come over here to the temple, show you the area. This was one of the builds that I helped with as well. I mean, it turned out just really, really nice. Like I said, the attention to detail, the fact that you see all the different types of materials that are in use, you know, the way that things are built, I think it really does capture the spirit of the things that you saw in Skyrim and the areas that you can go. And the best part was, is just like the folks at Bethesda, when they build stuff, we also put Easter eggs in. There's all sorts of hidden little areas. When this map is made available to the public, I believe Rongo will be making a copy of the files available. What you'll be able to do is you'll be able to download it and actually walk through this yourself. If you put it up on a multiplayer server, that's where you're going to see the best results with this, I think. And I think that, it would be a really good map for a community of players. So if you do put it up on multiplayer, let me know, because I would love to see how people make it their own. And that was just another one of the houses that I was part of the build of. I think I've worked on, yeah, I worked on all of these. I did the loft area in here. Not only did I help build the place, I ended up building the loft area here, as well as these rooms. And then the house next to it is actually a mirror of this one. So when you come in, you've got, you know, your stairwell here and the loft space and another bedroom. This one, I think, was our fastest build. We did this entire build in, I think, 10 minutes. From groundbreaking all the way through to putting the last piece in. It was ridiculous. We ended up doing this house and these two houses all in one sitting. I mean, it was like one episode for all of that. And then we came back for a second episode to finish off the stone house over near the planter there. And then you have this one, which is another house that I ended up working on a good portion of the upstairs. I think I did the floor in here as well, and then put in the spiral staircase. This is actually in one of the videos on my channel, so if you haven't seen it, definitely go check that out. It was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed hanging out with the folks in Broken Ankle. It was a great experience, not only hanging out with them, but actually being able to spend time with these guys and work on something that was just so, I don't know, just spectacular by the time everything was said and done. We have the Hall of the Dead in the mythos of the Elder Scrolls. This is where basically it is the cemetery style area where you would go to recognize your predecessors, your ancestors. And as you can see here, a lot of again, interesting detail work. If you can see up here, actually, we're gonna go in God mode really quick. They've actually put coffins and things up in here. So we have a little bit of everything in this place. This was a really fun build. I think this actually took us, I think we worked on this for about 3 hours or so total build time, maybe a little bit more, closer to 4 hours. And then there's a stairwell here. I'll leave that for you to go explore because this is definitely one of the areas you want to come check, take a look. Now, we put a skylight in here because it was so bloody dark. We didn't want people tripping over things, and we didn't want to kill frame rates with all of the torches and stuff. So, I think it works really, really well. I was really surprised how well that came out, actually. That's a Mafke design, I believe. It's been so long we've been working on all of these. It's just all kind of bleeds together. They did finish the cemetery as well. And we're just gonna go up here. So we're gonna go into the palace area now. We never cleaned up all of our building chests. All right, so this is actually Dragon's Reach. You have to see this place at night. With the torches and the way that everything is as you come up that path, it is just ridiculously imposing. Like I said, this map really benefits from having multiple people on it. I know when we were doing the builds, anytime we had less than like 4 or 5 people, the map just feels absolutely desolate. So you even have the path back here going down into the dungeons. We have the keep proper up there. We have the lower keep here, the Great Hall area. And I'm gonna do a shortcut right there. You do have the lake as well. And again, this is one of the areas that you definitely want to come visit just because it is such a notable landmark in the game of Skyrim. We have our chests. All of these things, like the chests and stuff, will probably come through and clear out before we make the mod or the map accessible. But you have the Great Hall. This particular build took an, oh, I don't know. Let me see. The last day that we worked on it, we built about a third, yeah, about a third of this place, and it was about 5 hours on the server. It is ridiculously ornate and overly detailed. As you can see, we have the walkways upstairs, we have the little cubbies and the side rooms for people, for the noted characters. There is the throne and fire pits here. It's just, yeah, I have, like I said, it was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed my time on the server, especially with the community, and I cannot wait to see what the community and the Broken Ankle crew do again in the future. Looks like we've got some furnishings in here now. Got an empty corpse, because you never can have too many of those, and he almost looks like he's up to be served here. So we're gonna go this way because we are not cannibals. Take you up into the strategy room. This is where, if you've played the game, you are talking to the Earl, and this is where his chambers are, or the Jarl, I should call him. This is his strategy and planning room. And then you have the platform, the landing platform for the dragon. So, this was, yeah, like I said, it was a lot of fun. I am extremely humbled by the amount of work that was done by so many people. The support from the community over this build, it just, yeah, absolutely amazing. You know what? Let's show you this from the air. Now, over the course of our build, you've seen different angles. You've seen a lot of the different portions of it. But let me show you what this looks like. So you have the private chambers up here. We've got the, I set up a little patio area out here. But as you can see, this build is so large that you can't see all of the build areas without actually flying around. I mean, look at this. You're so far outside the render range. To give you an idea, Dragon's Reach is actually so large that we ran into the physical build limitations of the map. We just had so much in here that the game itself stopped rendering parts of the build. We had to actually downsize it a little bit to get it all in on and on screen. So yeah, this is Whiterun. It was a lot of fun. It was absolutely amazing time hanging out with everybody, and I cannot wait to do more with the Broken Ankle crew in the future. I want to say thank you to Rongo Mafki for the chance to even participate in the invite into Broken Ankle, as well as to the Broken Ankle and the rest of the server community. Thank you all for the support and the well-wishing on all of it. I mean, it's just, yeah, absolutely amazing. It's just phenomenal. Come over here. Let me show you one of the things that the community set up. So we needed a farm. And they started out with, you know, just this like little terraced area. We came back because the Broken Ankle crew would record like once or twice a week, right? We would come back in between recordings. This was done. And we were just like, what the hell? He came back. And I mean, this is just absolutely phenomenal. Look at this. They actually built a greenhouse area for the plants. And it's tiered. I mean, this is just nuts. Let's get in here really quick. I'll show you what we got here. So you have all of your different types of crops. They've even got the mushrooms out here, the blueberries. You have a way into the farm here from upstairs. That's the entrance to the community center. That's where we started our tour. If you come into the farm area, you come up this set of stairs. And is it this one? Yeah, this one. This will take you down into the mines and the community center. And I think somebody put in their own entrance right here, isn't it? Yep. And this will bring you up into the guard tower that's overlooking the area. And then once you're in here, you can get in and around the city. Just to show you where we are now. So you can overlook the farm from a couple of different areas that get you up into there, and you can also get up onto the walls. So yeah, that's the build. It's just so much fun. It was a great time. I really enjoyed it. Hopefully with the next one, we'll be able to get more people involved. If you are interested in participating in whatever we do next, definitely check out all of the Broken Ankle crew. Your best bet is to basically be part of the community and be a positive, active contributor to the community. And yeah, I think that is about it. So I'm going to go ahead and call this one here. I want to thank everybody for stopping in today. Would also once again like to thank the Broken Ankle crew and community, as well as the server community, for all of the support and ongoing friendships and just the general fun that we had. Because I mean, there were times when It was the only thing kept keeping us going was the friendships and the fun we were having together, because there were days when, yeah, this build just drove us absolutely nuts. So anyway, I'm gonna get take off. I hope everybody has a fantastic day, and hope to see you back here next time for more of the broken ankle sh break broken ankle shenanigans, as well as whatever we de end up building next. As always, folks, take care and be safe out there, everybody. Oh, time to stop at the cafe and get us a drink. Oh, we got beans. There we go. Oh, better than Starbucks. Oh, yeah.